You wouldn't attack an old man again, would you? Take a look.
Mm-hmm.
You're finally here. What kept you so long? There's nothing worth stopping for in this wasteland. You're a right lazy one. Even an old man like myself managed to overtake you. To the prison tower. It's a place where people who fought against Elysians were imprisoned. Beware of the leech monsters along the way. They are rampant here, and far worse than the people in the slums. You must have seen people infested with the leeches on your way here. Whatever remains of them ends up here. Some call them Mary's children. The Elysians burn her on the pyre for, supposedly, being a witch. Some say she consorted with Morlaeg Ban and gave birth to those monsters. The masses called her Mara. Mara. The name of one of Anuiel's damned usurpers. Originally, it was used to transport criminals and other goods. Workers and beggars settled around and gradually built a large city. Elysians burned this town many times out of fear of the plague, but it always started rebuilding the very next day. The Elysian Order finally gave up and even granted the city some autonomy. Ironically, the Thracian Plague broke out here in the following year. The people here had no chance escaping the plague. Mountains of corpses clogged the sewer, and Lake Rumar was filled with blood and decayed flesh. Then, they started burning corpses every day. I remember it like yesterday. Originally, Slode. A Slode crept into the sewer. He was a good lad, but he was too ugly to be accepted. And Elysians killed him because of his ugliness. Just before his death, the Slode spat some kind of liquid at the one surrounding him. This is how the Thracian Plague started.
All right.
Thank you. That spell looks dangerous. Keep your distance.
She is a priestess of Mara from the time of the Alessian Empire. Apparently, she was a healer who could cure the Thracian plague. But there are very few records of her left. All I know is that she was burned as a witch by the Alessian Order during the outbreak of the Thracian plague. They are former humans, twisted by the Thracian plague and Mary's blessing. They rot again and again until they lose their human form. I am tending the bonfire. Those leech monsters fear it. As long as you light a fire, you won't be attacked by them. Well, there are creatures like Atima who don't fear fire, but she is harmless.
All right then.
Talos, Talos, invincible Talos. Uncle Chaos told Atima about him. He said Talos is the ninth divine. But it is funny because there are only eight divines. No matter how many times Atima counts.
Khajiit even asked Mary, but she did not know.
The old mother said there was only one god, and now Atima is really confused. Atima is called Atima. It is a nice name, no? Playing with dolls. Look, Mary made a doll for Atima. You must be jealous now, no? Mary is very kind. She does not hurt Atima like her old mother. Atima hates her. Atima hates her old father, too. They hurt Atima. Bad child. Bad child, they said. Because Atima is a Khajiit, they made her wear a collar and beat her with the whip. Mary dislikes fire, but Atima likes it. It is very warm.
Until next time.
Are you Mara? To appear in the image of Alicia. Are you mocking us? Good. Stay silent. You have no right to speak as it is.
Why in oblivion would you interfere with us now? Don't you know what will happen to you tomorrow?
I was not informed who you are, and I don't care whether you truly are her or just her imitation. But tomorrow, you will be condemned and burned in the pyre. And those kissing your feet today will throw you in the fire tomorrow at my merest gesture. Are you aware of this? Yes, I think you are. Look at the stone. Can you turn the stone into bread? Of course not. How could you? Man shall not live by bread alone. Weren't those your words? And, as if by Shazar's will, a Daedra rose up against you in the name of this bread. It can't have escaped you how the masses followed this Daedra in droves. Mundus is full of the starving. And it was them, shouting for bread and salvation, who tore down your tower. I'm sure you intended to raise a new one, but it's useless. You will not complete even the foundations of the Tower of Fate. If you had not tried to build a tower, you might have been able to alleviate the suffering of the people, but you did not. And what did the people do? They came to us, the Elysian Order, crying that the ones who promised to steal the heart of Shazar lied to them. If you truly are Mara, then accept this stone. Then its fires will fade, and this abominable tragedy will end. But you will not accept it. For one who denies the miracle also denies the Aedra. People would rather believe in the miracles than in the Aedra. So much so that they even create their own miracles, and would soon believe even an inquisitor like me. You do not want to make people slaves to the miracle. Their freedom of faith is more important to you, was it not? Your love for the people was simply too deep. It would have been better if you hadn't loved them at all. They would not have to go hungry then. But neither your love nor their free will is important. Just this mystery, this stone. Even if every last living being has to betray their consciousness, they must submit to this stone. Elysian Order was created for this, so we had to rewrite your teachings. We built our tower on top of miracles, mystery, and authority. We released people from this freedom, this free will, which can only bring them endless pain. And so, with the permission of the Elysian Order, we were compassionate to the weak, even despite their sins. Is this not proof of our love for the people? I will ask you again. Why in oblivion did you come to disturb us? The stuff of the Aedra belongs to the Aedra. The stuff of the Emperor to the Emperor. With those words, you wanted to deny us the stone, am I right? This stone is our authority on Nern, and we will never give it up. Even if we have to renounce you and worship a simple slave queen. Already, 2,000 years passed since the Imga Prophet found the stone in the dense jungles of Kolovia. The tower has been waiting completion since then, but sooner or later, it will be completed. And then, everyone will live in bliss. Why did you reject the stone if you wanted to give people hope? Could you not turn Mundus to paradise with it? You could have united everyone, masters and servants alike. Perhaps you couldn't do it, but we, the Elysian Order, can. With this stone, we will build a great empire, spanning across the entire continent. With this stone in our hands, our empire does not have to wait for the return of Shazar. What I said will happen, and our empire will rise. And tomorrow, you will see the people flock to us, like the obedient sheep they are. At my side, they will willingly place firewood at your feet, and you know why? Because you tried to stop us. If there's anyone in Mundus who deserves to be burned on the pyre, then it is you. Tomorrow, you will die. Then it will finally be over. Go! Go! Don't come back! Never come back! Never! Never!
Ha ha!